Hello guys, so today we are going to discuss important questions from the topic stock brokers. So these questions are very important for your SEBI grade examination. So those of you who are preparing for SEBI grade examination will find these questions very helpful. And guys, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. Now moving on to the first question, which of the below statements are incorrect with respect to stock brokers? So in this question, you are given a few statements regarding stockbrokers. So you have to see which of these are incorrect, right? So statement one, the transaction entered cannot be cancelled or made invalid except in the case of fraud, misrepresentation or in case of a material mistake. So this statement is basically saying that a transaction which is entered by a stockbroker, it cannot be cancelled. But there are some exceptions when the transaction can be cancelled. So the transaction entered by a stockbroker can be cancelled in case of fraud or in case of misrepresentation or in case of a material mistake. So material means some big mistake, right? So in these cases, the transaction can be cancelled. Otherwise, the transaction cannot be cancelled. So this statement is correct. Next statement, the stockbroker needs to issue a contract note for every transaction specifying whether he is acting as a principal or agent. So I hope all of you know what is the meaning of principal and agent. So in the context of stock market, if the broker has entered into a transaction on his own account, so if a broker buys or sells security for its own profit directly, then he is acting as a principal. But if the broker is acting on behalf of its client, then he is acting as an agent. So simple, principal and agent. Now this statement is correct because the broker has to issue a contract note for every transaction in which he is entering, and also he needs to specify whether he is acting as a principal or he is acting as an agent for his client. So statement 2 is also correct. Now statement 3, while buying or selling securities as a principal for the clients, the stock broker has to obtain the consent of SEBI. So how a broker can act as a principal for the client? So let's suppose there is a broker X and there is a client A. A is the client of X. So let's suppose A placed an order with his broker X that he wants to buy 100 shares of Reliance. So let's suppose A placed an order of 100 shares of Reliance. Now the role of broker generally is to find the seller of 100 shares of Reliance. So this is the normal agency business of a broker. But if the broker is holding the shares of Reliance and is selling those shares to his client, then he is acting as a principal, because in that case he is the seller. So if a broker is acting as a principal, like in this case, then he needs to obtain the consent of his client. So this statement is wrong. Why? Because the broker needs to obtain the consent of client and not SEBI, right? So the consent of client is required when the broker is acting as a principal. So statement 3 is incorrect. And statement 4, the stock brokers need to be registered with Companies Act 2013 in order to function as brokers. So this statement is incorrect. Why? Because the broker needs to register with SEBI and not Companies Act. So SEBI Act 1992. So statement 4 is also incorrect. So 1 and 2 are correct and 3 and 4 are incorrect. So the correct option is D. 3 and 4 are incorrect. Moving on to the next question. Question number 2. Which of the following statements are incorrect in respect of stockbrokers? So here you are given 3 statements. You have to see which are incorrect. So statement 1, stockbroker may act as principal or agent. As I have already told you in the previous question, a broker can act as principal also or as an agent also. It is acting as principal when it trades for its own account. It is acting as an agent when it executes orders on behalf of its clients. So this statement is right, as I have already told you in the previous question. Statement 2, for each transaction, broker has to issue a debit note. So this statement is wrong. Why? Because in the first question itself, I told you that a broker needs to issue a contract note for every transaction. So it is not debit note. It is not debit note. It is contract note, right? So statement 2 is incorrect. And statement 3, a broker has to obtain consent of its client while buying or selling securities as a principal. So this statement is also correct. As I have told you that if a broker is buying or selling securities as a principal, then the consent of client is required. So in this case, only statement 2 is incorrect. So the correct option is C. Statement 2 is incorrect. Moving on to the third question. So which of the following statements are not correct with respect to stock brokers for grant of certificate? So grant of certificate. So I have told you that every stock broker needs to obtain a certificate of registration from SEBI. So every stock broker is required to register with SEBI if it wants to operate in the stock market, right? So here are some statements with regard to grant of certificate. So there are separate regulations for stock brokers, SEBI regulations. So there are stock broker and sub broker regulations 1992. So they talk about the registration part and what are the eligibility conditions for a stock broker. So before granting certificate of registration, SEBI will look into various aspects, right? So let us see statement 1. He has the necessary infrastructure. He here means stockbroker. He has the necessary infrastructure like adequate office space, equipment, manpower to effectively discharge his activities. So this statement is right. So SEBI will ensure that the broker has adequate office space, equipment, manpower so that he can perform the functions of broker adequately and effectively. So statement 1 is correct. Statement 2. So SEBI will see whether he has any past experience in the business of buying, selling or dealing in securities. So this statement is also correct. So SEBI will also see whether the applicant has any past experience in the business of buying, selling or dealing in securities. So the past experience is required, right? And statement 3, whether he was subjected to disciplinary proceeding under the rules, regulations and bylaws of a stock exchange with respect to his business of a stock broker involving either himself or any of his partner, director or employees. So statement 3 is also right. So basically SEBI will see that the applicant has not violated any rules or bylaws of the stock exchange. So the applicant must not have violated the rules himself, and also his partner, director or employee should also not have violated the rules. So SEBI will check whether the applicant was subject to any disciplinary action in the past or not. So basically the past records of the applicant will be checked, right? So statement 3 is also correct. Statement 4, he has a net worth of 500 crore or more. So this statement is incorrect because no such net worth requirement of 500 crore has been specified, right? So accordingly, option B is correct. Only 4 is incorrect, right? Moving on to the next question. Question 4. Now before discussing the question, I would like to tell you that I have discussed this topic on our Telegram group also. So on our group, we regularly post questions and conduct quizzes. Also, the relevant information regarding exams is being shared on the group. So do join our Telegram group to get the benefits. The link for the group is provided in the description section below. Now question 4. Chapter 2 of the SEBI regulations 1992 deals with the registration process of a stockbroker. Which of the following statements is not correct with respect to registration process? So you are given some statements regarding registration process as per SEBI regulations regarding stockbrokers. So I will explain the process to you in brief. So first of all, broker needs to fill form A. There is a form, form A. So this is the registration form for the stockbroker. So the applicant needs to fill this form A and submit it to the stock exchange in which the applicant is a member. Then the stock exchange will forward the application to the SEBI. And the stock exchange needs to forward the application within 30 days. So within 30 days of receiving form from the applicant, the stock exchange needs to submit the form to SEBI. So afterwards, SEBI will see whether the applicant is eligible to be registered as a broker. So the various eligibility conditions which I discussed in the previous question, like whether the applicant has adequate space, whether he has past experience in the business, etc. Now if SEBI is satisfied that the applicant is eligible, then it will issue a certificate in form D. So it will grant certificate in form D, certificate of registration, to the applicant. But if SEBI feels that the applicant is not eligible, so it will not grant the certificate. So in case SEBI does not grant the certificate, then the applicant can again apply to the SEBI within 30 days of receiving the communication. So it can apply again within 30 days for reconsideration of the SEBI decision. So basically this is the process. So now let us see the statements. Statement first, applicant needs to fill form A to apply for registration. So applicant, so it is applicant, not application. Applicant needs to fill form A to apply for registration. So this is right, as I've just shown you in the diagram below. Now statement 2, the form needs to be submitted to SEBI by the applicant. So this statement is wrong. Why? Because the form needs to be submitted to the stock exchange, right? Then stock exchange will submit it to SEBI. So the applicant does not have to submit the form directly to SEBI. Rather, the applicant will submit form to stock exchange and the stock exchange will submit it to SEBI, right? So statement B is incorrect. Statement C, if SEBI finds the applicant eligible, it will grant certificate in form D. So this is right, as I've just told you. So if the SEBI finds the applicant eligible, then it will grant the certificate to the applicant in form D. And last statement, if applicant is denied certificate by SEBI, it can apply again to SEBI for reconsideration of decision within 30 days. So yes, this is also right. So statement B is incorrect. So B is the correct option. Now next question, question 5. Section 15F of SEBI Act 1992 prescribes penalty in case of default by stockbroker. In case a broker fails to deliver security or fails to make payment due to the investor in the stipulated period as per SEBI regulations 2018, then what is the maximum penalty? So these are basically amendment regulations of 2018. Otherwise the regulations for stockbrokers were 1992 regulations, but these are the new amendment regulations. So they are asking you about the maximum penalty. So before that, I will like to tell you that in the SEBI Act of 1992, there are various penalties for various violations of the act, right? So there are various sections like 15A, 15B, 15C, 15D, and there are others also. So basically these sections, they contain penalties for various violations of the act. So accordingly, there is a section 15F of SEBI Act. So it talks about penalties for stockbrokers. So if the stockbroker default, then there are penalties, right? So in case a broker fails to deliver security or fails to make payment to the investor, either of the two, then section 15F says that the broker is liable to a penalty. So broker is liable to a minimum penalty of 1 lakh, but this penalty will extend to 1 lakh for each day during which the broker is in default. But the maximum penalty or the maximum limit is 1 crore, right? So they are asking about the maximum penalty. So the penalty, the maximum limit on the penalty is 1 crore and minimum is 1 lakh. And the penalty will be 1 lakh for each day. So for each day during which the default continues, right? So the maximum penalty here is 1 crore. So the correct option is B, 1 crore. Now moving on to the next question. So question 6, an applicant may, being aggrieved by the decision of the board regarding grant of certificate of registration of broker, may apply within a period of how many days from the date of receipt of such intimation to the board for reconsideration of its decision. So this is regarding the registration part. So I have already discussed this in the previous questions, right? So I hope you will be able to solve this question. So I am not giving you the answer. So you need to mention the answer in the comment section below, right? So your options are 60 days, 30 days, 90 days and 10 days. So within how many days an applicant who is aggrieved by the decision of SEBI can apply for reconsideration of decision, right? So guys, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do hit the subscribe button to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.